today's tea is, I'm actually not sure how to pronounce it, Ceylon. It's from Sri Lanka. But it's quite a little tasty, rich black tea. Not entirely unlike English breakfast, but it's very nice. Also organic. Okay, anyway, that was tea time. Let's talk about some Go stuff. Today, in this video, I do want to look at two games by my friend Martin. And I want to show you Martin's secret to getting better at Go. It's not really much of a secret, but let's take a look. Here's actually Martin. If we go back and we look, we can actually see that a couple of years ago, you know, he was in double-digit Q range, which I imagine most of you, or not maybe most, but a plurality of you probably are, who are watching this video. And he sort of just sort of leveled off right around maybe 6-7 Q, depending on the day. And then something really magical happens, starting here, like right around March, April, May. We just see the skyrocket of Go ability. And so what made Martin, after stalling out for, you know, over a year, all of a sudden start to accelerate in his Go skills again? I wonder. Well, I'm gonna give you just a second to think about it. And the secret was that he subscribed to Nick Zabicki's Go Lessons for the World Patreon. I'm actually only half kidding about this. Like, he really did. He became a supporter. And boom, look at the results. Like, you pledge $2 a month and look what you can do. Isn't that amazing? Actually, in all seriousness, though, just becoming a Patreon backer of me or any other Go content creator does not make you better at Go, just to be clear. But actually, it did give him almost like I don't want to say a financial incentive, but it made him committed, you know, just that $2 pledge. And so he's actually been working quite hard at it, and you can see the results. Like, look at this rating, like going up 3 stones from 6Q to 3Q in a relatively short amount of time here is pretty, you know, I mean, impressive. I mean, especially once you've sort of reached, you know, a rank that you stalled at. In a separate email, he wrote me and he said, you know, at this game, I keep getting better and then I'll stall out. And then I'll get a little bit better, but then I'll stall out. And, you know, it's very hard to have continuous successful growth. And that's my story, too. I mean, I certainly had the same experience with the game. And I think a lot of you guys can relate to that. But I think a story like Martin's is always welcome, because you can see how someone sort of broke through that, right? Gets stuck, and then, you know, you can see it in the data. Isn't that cool? You guys love graphs? I love graphs. So anyway, enough of that aside. If you, too, want to be like Martin, you can go to my Patreon page and support the making of these videos. I do apologize. I haven't actually gotten, I think, a new lecture on really online about maybe last week and a half or so, maybe even 2 weeks. I don't remember the last date I uploaded it. It's been a while. It's been far too long. I actually have still been recording lessons. I just haven't been having enough time and energy to get them edited and online. So I'm a little bit backed up here. But today we're going to try to turn that around. We'll definitely try to get this online sooner than later. But anyway, let's look at some games of Martin and see how you get really good at this game in a short amount of time. This game, Martin, is black. And pretty normal standard opening here. And we're going to play a Joseki. Oh, this is not Joseki. interesting. All right, so after this connection... Man, I don't remember what Joseki is. That's weird. I should actually look these up before I play them. Why do I feel like it's this one? There's still this ladder. This is only a Joseki that. What did I just do? That didn't make any sense. Right, and then take. There we go. There's this ladder here, but black can only play this if black has the ladder, or white can only, I think white can. Well, why haven't I seen this Joseki in so long? Oh, right, because often we play here. This is also Joseki. These are both Joseki, to be fair. All right, this is where I need to play more Go, because I haven't actually thought about this Joseki in so long. It's kind of embarrassing. So maybe that move is okay. Yep, and black has a ladder, so this will basically be the same. All right, good. I'm not sure... this feels even enough. Here, you guys yell at me enough on the internet. You can guys go look up the Joseki and just put the correct move in the comments that I missed. We'll leave it there. Okay, so I like this move here. This is good. We're sort of keeping a little bit of focus on this ladder, but really when you pincer like this, what black is looking to do is to build this bottom, and that's very reasonable. I still feel like with this corner, like somehow white got a better deal in this situation, just because of that ladder, odd G. Okay, yep, it's good. And, oh, neat move. So normally we'd expect to move here. And in this type of situation, this white stick doesn't really have any friends, right? This would be the more normal continuation. And it's actually hard to make a base. White would actually have to make a bunch of really crude moves here or here, but usually you play this one if you're going to play one of these. White can make these exchanges and start to make something like a base, but it's still not really guaranteed two eyes yet. So this is still actually quite poor for white, because white will still need to struggle. In the game, white plays here, which is quite interesting. And black pushed up. I'm not sure if I like this push. It's reasonable. It's actually reasonable, but is it better? I'm just looking at other options like this. Can we get away with playing this? It's sort of taking away that shape point. Because the problem with pushing is that white pulls back here. Of course, white didn't pull back here. And it doesn't feel like we gained a whole lot in the corner, because black still needs this move to basically take away white's base. And then white gets sent in and can play here because of this stone. So this is my objection with when black pushes up. It seems like, if black tries to do something over here, white can do this, maybe lean here, get an eye and get enough out. Black might get pressed very low. Yeah, not in love with that, not in love. So, what do we do? We could take this way immediately, but this gives white very good shape as well. So I don't like that. Connecting doesn't quite work yet. It'd work better if this stone was actually like third line, because then we could actually link it up to something, right? If you imagine we had a black stone here, we could actually undercut. So it's an interesting move. It feels like it might be a little bit slow. Maybe the best move is here. And by this way, we're protecting ourselves. We're actually still exposing this weakness. If white wants to turn there, then we can threaten to do this sort of slice through kind of thing, where white has no eye space. The other thing that this does is when white decides to play more aggressive and try to lean here, we can actually cut here fairly strongly. And again, if white is just looking to get out, we can get a lot more territory. So that feels better to me, but already I can see that from the tree that white doesn't play here, white plays there. That looks kind of butt ugly. That looks like a bad move for white. Do you cut immediately? Yeah, that feels right. White thinks he's being tricky. We're just going to exchange? Something just happened. Did it run my recorder stop? Something just flashed on my screen. Very tricky, very tricky. But I'm not convinced that this is bad for you. What happens if you do this and this? I mean, you can give white this corner, right? But you just would own the entire outside. This would be a glorious result for black. Those four white stones are just trash. White could push through this way, but that would give you a big corner, and this white stick doesn't really have anything to do. It'd have to lean over here to try to make some sort of eye space. But even then, it's actually really difficult, because it's not like white can just ladder this stone cleanly because of this push up here. Although, I mean, this would be fine for white if white actually got to play in here, because it disrupt this ladder too. But, so maybe we don't, when white cuts here, maybe we just give up the stone. And we take Sente and take another big move. And this would also, I think this would also be fine for black. We got to capture the three stones here. So, that's a variation. So, this feels fine to me. What else can white do? White could do this sort of thing where he gives up a stone, and then starts a ko. You could do this ko variation. Actually, this is a pretty terrifying ko for black. Is this a local threat? Not really. Oh, this is not a ko. This is a one-step ko, though. Which white really has no way to fight a one-step ko in the opening. So that'd be also success for black. All right, so what did you do? You played there. That's too bad, right? Because white just takes the stone now. Oh, that's too bad. Oh, so sad, Martin. So these fights, yeah, like I think before you play the sitar, you have to have a plan for how you're going to save this stone. Like, in this formation, this stone is actually not important. These two stones are, and this one star is. Stone. These two stones are, and this one stone is. So, you know, you can see that if you play this, right, even if you, it doesn't really matter if you made this exchange or not, these two stones lose the capturing race over here. So it would have actually been even better for you if you played this way. This might also be an acceptable solution, because you can see, you could take this Atari first, if you really wanted to. But this way would also work for black, where you would eat the corner. White could split you over here. And then white would have to ladder this. I don't like this variation, though, because, again, if it goes to this ladder, white owns this ladder, and this is white would be satisfied capturing this one cutting stone. So I think we missed a really big opportunity here. I think we were just one move off. Just involves some reading. These three stones, even though they're not strong at all, white can't kill them directly. So we actually have time to find a move like that. So that's too bad. Yep, so of course, and then we just give up. Oh, such a good result for white. Such a good result for white. Even though black gets a few free moves later, white is super strong. Black's low over here, still has weaknesses, lots of weaknesses, super thin shape. This seems like a really bad move for white, actually. Maybe not really bad, because what white is thinking is, if he takes sente, black will take this in sente whenever he wants. So he's taking the reverse sente move, right? It's sente for black, therefore I should play it. But the thing is, black doesn't need to respond to this directly. Yeah, good, and so you don't. So even though white just had a great result, he played a little bit too slow of a move afterward. So we are still in this. this seems a little aggressive for white. Playing on the fourth line. I mean, the third line would be so much more reasonable because you could settle more easily. I think white's trying to attack these three stones, which is his right. But the problem is that your stones are on the fourth line, can easily get out. And this one stone still has Aji. I think this is probably a poor exchange. I think you should just play here. This is my gut feeling. White will, of course, make these exchanges and then have to play something like this. But again, these are both, I think, maybe valid. I'm not sure which one's better off the top of my head. Ways to deal with this. Again, you can prevent white from having a base similarly to how we could have done it earlier. How would white attack this? This might be too aggressive. Much too aggressive. Nothing works, right? Black can actually just slice through here. I don't know. So I would have to jump out slowly. But this is probably too... is actually definitely too slow of a move. Just oriented about points. I realize it's really dark in this room right now. I also didn't put up my green screen nor my fancy lights. So you're just getting my two little table lamps worth of light here. So I apologize for the low quality production today. Sorry, Martin. This move is sente. I mean, I'm not, especially after white has taken the S2, I'm not completely opposed to taking all this stuff right now. It feels like it gives us at least almost completely solid two eyes. Yeah, so I'm not in love with this move here. Let's see how it plays out, though. Ooh, so white's going to attach this way. This is asking for a lot. So in this case, It's the shape is really, really important. Basically, whoever has the strongest shape coming out of this is going to win. My gut reaction is wanting to play here. Of course, that gives white this move. But I think that, you know, because you have this stone already here, I think you can play this way. And it's actually very, very hard on white, because if white takes this atari, you come out this way, and it looks like white's kind of split into pieces. So that's one avenue. The other one you could consider here is playing here. Now, the problem with this, of course, is that it gives white this type of co-sequence, just to make life. You could play this way, but I don't think it's actually that much better. White might... I guess white doesn't quite have enough to link up here. Because, again, you have this type of sente move. Yeah, maybe this way works, too. Maybe you don't need to play this co, because you can peep here. Of course, is there a problem if we go this way? Because we need to take this stone now, otherwise white just has fun. This might not be a bad thing for white, because it feels like now here, white actually can't cut through very strongly. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe white can still play this way. But when you come back and fix this cut, there's this sequence here that maybe isn't that as bad as I think it is. but here's what I'm seeing, right? I'm seeing these two stones and these two stones, and now even though it looks like the same shape as before in the corner, white has already stones down here, a strong stone at S13, or relatively. I mean, it's a four liberty group, so it's not super strong, but it's something. Already undercutting this. So I'm seeing three weaknesses for black in black. Even though black, you know, did get a lot stronger by capturing this one, this would worry me a lot more. Certainly something to consider, but it's a hard read. When you play here, we're just asking for weaknesses to be left. Yep, white plays the obvious move, and you back off, and now you have to play a strong move and fix. But unfortunately, it just gives white more opportunity to start making shape. Yep. Okay, so white exchanges that and then comes back and takes. White's still kind of in trouble, though. White's kind of in trouble, even here. So this worked out well for you. What could white have done? Yeah. Can white play this? I mean, I know you can cut here, but that doesn't really accomplish anything. Yeah, what happens in white plays here? Is this linked up? Is there a way to split this? Black would have to play here, right? But then white could play here. And black would have to play... No, black could play here now. This cut's kind of big. If you play here... No, we have to connect. Black really needs one more move here and here. This is playable. This is reasonable. All right. But we play... White plays a little more crudely and gives black... Actually, so the same sort of, like, double tiger's mouth-ish kind of shape white was trying to make over here, black gets to make over here. All right, so this is the game. Yep. Comes out. White is aggressive. Does this even work? Is this like a good idea? This feels like a terrible, horrific overplay. Did you punish? Yeah! Alright. Growing less confident? Feels like you'd have to play here. And I know it looks like white gets out easily. But you're not trying to necessarily guarantee that white can't cut here. You're just trying to make it the most awkward thing possible for white to cut. Also, I wonder, how well does this work? Not well at all. Yeah, not well at all. Whoops, no, oh my gosh. So, when white pops here, I kind of like just this. This also makes it sets up a big move somewhere over here, M4-ish, to basically seal in this white group. And this white group, I guess it has a more or less guaranteed two eyes, but you might... There is sort of like a code to take this one away. You can pop this one out later, even though it's still two eyes, but it's barely two eyes. So maybe if you get a free move somewhere later, it is something. All right, so anyway, it looks like you... Okay, you're going to let white push again, and now you're going to come back and make that shape that I wanted you to begin with. And now you're actually in a little bit more trouble this time. Yeah, so now you connect, and white connects, and now this cut is very much looming, and these four stones are separated. So, you fix the cut. All right, let's just compare this. You guys see what this looked like? Oh, and white's going to press there. Feels like, well, white needs moves everywhere. So, all right, I'm not going to argue with white too much here, but just keeping these separated also feels really good. This move feels really necessary, but I know white could at least play here. The liberties aren't that important for black. Black has enough liberties. So white, if white's going to run out this way, white should probably just play there. All right, so you have this board state in your head. If we go back and do things my way, let's see what it looks like. And connect, probably jump. Does this just work? Does this prevent this cut? Looks like it. Totally, right? So that would prevent that cut. White could still make this cut. But again, I'm actually okay with white making this cut because now, once we get more stones running this way, we still have this weak group here, and this is also weak too. Of course, black will start a third fight and make this weak by slicing through here. But this seems expected. But totally not what happened in the game. So instead of having all those weak groups, basically, we get a weak white group. That's the only white weak group. And we also get a black weak group here, and an almost kind of weak black group here. So I just feel like this, in the game, you ended up with giving your opponent fewer weaknesses to worry about. These exchanges feel really slow for white. Yep, good. This might be a little bit too much, because once white does actually get out, this leaves a whole lot of Aji back here. So if you're gonna be greedy and just take points from attacking this, this is going to be a much better move. I'm not convinced it's actually time to take points yet. I think we should just keep pressure on. Even if you do something like this, it doesn't look like white can actually do anything very severe to this black weak group over here. Like this just is nothing, right? Or connect this side. White can try to attack this group. This would be better for white. But still, as long as this group... first of all, this white group is bigger than this black group. So if this white group dies, then black has gained. All right, so white jumps out again. That seems reasonable. And Tanuki? Oh. I don't think I like it. I think this is a bad time to Tanuki. And again, it's a bad time because I'm looking at white playing move over here and again threatening this group. And if white has a stone here, then white can push through and wedge, cut, or clamp, do any of these type moves over here and separate these four stones, which will in turn keep this big long black group really weak. This is kind of like the don't go fishing when your house is on fire proverb. There's too many weak groups running around over here. You're probably thinking that white will get a lot of points over here and will just connect up, and this stone will prevent that, and it's maybe helping attack this, but it's not. It's just not. I think white doesn't get the idea either. White did fail to get the memo that there are still weak groups on the board. So this move is fine. locally, but again, globally, it's a little lacking. Oh, good. So black actually gets to come back and play here. That's a huge move. Because now black is actually building something with all these weak groups, or at least trying to. There's still problems here. For instance, there's just like this immediate co that white can just capture all these. But that's kind of been there for a while. But at least this is in the right direction. Maybe the shape doesn't quite work out. There's also problems like this, where if we care about these black five stones, basically we die here. But this whole black stick gets surrounded. So again, there's this weak area here, and there's this very weak area here, and we care about both of those very much as black. So I like the fact this is in the correct direction. Oh, that is the game. White actually cuts through right here. Interesting. Oh, that's the game. That's totally the game. Oh, and then white plays here. This is making the fight really huge. Instead of just basically attacking these five white stones, white is trying to attack this entire thing from over here. And I'm not saying it's impossible. Maybe white's actually just a much better go player than I am, and is having bigger dreams. This is very possible. Oh, we're playing with fire, but the direction is good. I kind of wonder if you need a more severe move, quite honestly. Something like this. But we'll see. We'll see. Yep, so white runs out. And we're using these two stones to attack this whole thing. This whole thing. Now we gotta run out. Okay, so white pushes. Oh, you defend there. Is this, are we worried about the ladder? If you're already gonna play once over here, it feels like we need to play over here again. But, yeah, that's a really good move for white. Maybe white gets one eye. But can white get a second eye? Maybe you can just kill white. Or there. I don't know. I don't know what the shape move is. It's exciting, though. We just got exciting. So white, black. This is very greedy. Very greedy. Yep, that's a big move. And you defend that ladder move. Again, in this type of situation, because you also have this group of two stones over here, you have C5, which is kind of like Sente. Yeah, it's basically Sente. This ladder might not be as important. So that's something to consider. All right, this is looking bad. Oh, now white takes the shape point. Okay. So we're just going to keep up attacking the whole thing. Again, keep up attacking the whole thing. We have cuts now to worry about. What? What? Oh, this actually makes life, huh? I see. White's going for the uber kill. Right, because I was assuming white would try to just play some move like this that would help out this group and attack this. Maybe that's a little bit too far, but something in this area. Black does have this sequence to live. I see. Not a lot. That white could do to prevent this life. Okay. I mean, that would live outright. So white's trying to prevent that. So, just going back here. Yeah, this move is just like off my radar. This move actually is very helpful for making life. All right. All right, so white's going to cut anyway, is where we're at. Oh, wait, what? No, I missed a black move. Black tried to get out, completely ignoring this cut. Does this cut not work? Oh, it just goes to a capturing race. I see. Yep. And that should be a good capturing race for black. It looks like you're going to have it. Oh, no, you're not guaranteed an eye. Exciting. Yep. Start the race. Make a... I'm not sure if this is a good move. Feels like this would have just been better. Just threaten this directly. Yeah, but look, it still just looks like Black wins this capturing race. At the very least, it's Seki, but it looks like Black wins. So, again, yeah, White didn't have time to play this. Even though, yeah, White's trying to kill everything, White needed to make his own group safe first. Even a move like this would be more forward-thinking. This is a hard thing to do, right? Because this involves reading, right? I mean, White has done a good job reading, like, okay, I need to play here if I want to prevent Black from getting two eyes. But Black hasn't done a good job enough reading, and what happens if Black gets another move against this group first? White doesn't need eyes to live, or sorry, Black doesn't need eyes to live if he can just capture all this. So, yep, that's probably one move too many. This cut doesn't work. Again, at this point, White should just be trying to get liberties. And threaten connection, threaten to capture something. Threaten something, anything other than making this cut. I think if White makes this cut, White loses the game. That doesn't quite work. Yeah, and not only did we give up a stone here and create this false eye, we had to work hard to create this false eye. We also essentially just give Black an opportunity to make an eye here, or come back and make an eye here. So we've now given Black two different ways to make an eye in this shape. White takes away one. I think Black should actually play here first. That feels... Oh, it doesn't matter. Yeah, it doesn't really matter. Never mind. So Black will make this eye. Atari. All right, trying to get liberties now. Oh, all right, we should actually look at this more carefully. How did White get so many liberties so fast? Oh, because Black made an eye. Yeah, White needs... I think you just need to cut. Maybe you're worried about this group over here, these four black stones. Looks really hard for White to come up with enough liberties, though. Can you actually even do this thing where you let White capture a stone? Let's say White has to fix. If it just goes to a straight-up capturing race, that doesn't work, right? White's an Atari, so White has to connect there. Yeah, White would win by one move, I guess. Because of that connection. Or, wait a second, did I go the wrong way? Yeah, White can't... Yeah, I went the wrong way. Sorry. If White goes here, Black goes here. Right, and now Black wins by a move. Of course, before playing that, White needs to play here. And now White wins by a move. So whoever gets K6 basically wins the capturing race, which is kind of weird, because I think it's like Dame for both people, but it's not. So both players kind of miss opportunities here. Yeah, even here, even in response to this, Black, I think, just does this. Because, again, this one black stone, not important. Black just connects. Even technically all these four stones aren't that important either. But this threatens to save the stone. Yep, and all these white stones would die. But in the game, White plays there. Wait, oh, this is the game. Black does play there. Cool. It's probably better to cut first. But... Or is it? No, maybe this is better. Maybe you did read it out correctly. Either way, Black needs that move. Cool. All right, now you cut. Oh, no, you didn't. Right, you did this. No, right? How does White respond to this? Are you worried about this? This stone's captured. We could even just play there, right? And just White has no liberties to do anything, right? There's nowhere to go for White. What am I missing? I'm not missing anything. This is like game over. Like any of these moves. This move is, I mean, all right, people. Just because you see an Atari doesn't mean you should take the Atari. It's just not useful. Not useful. Oh, man. White takes the Atari, not a big deal. And white sort of splices through here. Black does this. And we have Co for a whole bunch of more liberties. That's called giving white a chance. Don't usually like to give white a chance. So we have this Co. That doesn't feel big enough. No. All right. So, is that game over? Does white have a way to win? Oh, white's going to capture a little bit more. What just happened? That Co thread did nothing. That just did nothing. There's like no points, no value there. Yeah, this game is like over, right? Where does white come up with enough points on this board? I mean, white has to kill something at the top. Nope. White has to, like, do stuff like this, or like this, or like this. If white just plays normal moves here, where are the points? Here, we can do a quick count. White, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, that should be 8, 18, 19, 20, 21, maybe like in the 40s, maybe close to 50 after Comey for white. Meanwhile, black already has 14 captures, so it'll go 7. Again, I'm counting in pairs. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, let's say 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36. I mean, like, black's in the 70s, right? And it looks like white would have to work hard to invade this anyway. Okay, same idea. Yep, take advantage of the Aji, just seal this off. That's a big move. Yep, just give it up. Oh, not that way. So, here. Alright, if white plays here, let's connect here, right? Not better? Nah, it doesn't matter. Alright, well, if white's not gonna fight this Co, then this is fine. No, just give it up. This is very hard for white still. Oh, I see. No, white could play this way and cut this way and capture three more. Because of that Atari. All right. Yeah. Okay, so that'd be hard. Anyway, in the game you played there, and just let white poke through, fine. As long as we don't die, you're still going to win. You're up by so much. You just don't have to do much except don't die. Okay. White's trying to kill you. White needs to kill you. Huh? What happens if white plays here? We can do this. And this? Isn't this like a Co? Wouldn't that be like disaster? It is a one-step Co, right? Because after Atari take... Or not a one-step Co, but sorry. In the end, it looks like black will get to effectively take the Co first because of those local threats. That looks like Co to me. Yeah, now it's 3 to 4 liberties. No, it's not anything. What? Don't we have to respond? Oh, wait, what? I totally misread this. Huh? So white connected there. All right, so also, why aren't we just playing this? Is that really so bad? Why do you care about white having an eye? As long as you have enough liberties, you don't care if white has an eye. I think you're worried about this. But then in this variation, wait, we die again. What just happened? Why can't I play this game? I'm terrible today. This is actually a pretty terrible review. You guys probably shouldn't learn anything from this review. So here, wait, I don't want to play this move. Yeah, this is actually really tough. All right, let's go back a few moves. So when you play here, you think you're just letting white take what he wants. That's a pretty nice move. At least it feels nice, like if it works. But if you do this, what happens now? We still get this cut. Oh, white still wins that. Interesting. We can give up the stone, though, and do that way. There you go. Not dead. Because this 1-1, or 2-2 stone, sorry, is dead. So that would have been a way to give that up. This is the normal move, right? Are we scared of this? Probably. Yeah, this is a really interesting move. Oh, wait, what about this? This move. Play here. Here. Take. Die. Does that just work? Like, this doesn't work, right? What is what white would have to just give up, I think. Whoops, not that one. Or is white thinking about this? But again, this doesn't work. We can just capture. I think we just trap white on the inside. So maybe this is like the magical move. What's white's best continuation? Maybe there? And this looks like it's really similar, except we can come back and take this stone at any time. Which we don't get in the game. Alright, so I mean, this is a disaster for black. Like, capital D disaster. But it was tricky, it was tricky. But you should have been fine. Like, this shouldn't have been a problem. So if that's a capital disaster for black, is white winning? It seems like it. Here, let's keep going and see what happens. All right, that's fancy. White's being very pig-headed here, though. This is, I don't think that's right. Doesn't white just sort of have to give up a little bit? I'm not sure if black can extend. Yeah, I guess sorta. No, not really. No. Black would have to play this one. White would come back and we'd have a ladder. That works for black. Neat. Okay. So this move is like really, really greedy. Feels like white should just do this. Just let black link up, and then everything's connected. Any other responses? Or we could just play this. This also just works, right? Like, just flat out works. Yeah, clamp's probably the better move. Alright, but white wanted to play this. So now we get to have fun go time. Oh dear. Hang on to your butts. What's the liberty count at? Not actually. Actually, maybe white's completely fine. No, definitely fine if we play that move, right? That'll only give black one eye versus a million liberties. What? Oh, no, it gives black. There is two eyes there, right? Because there's a slink up here. I see. I was thinking here, but this is basically. Well, maybe not. We have this move. Man, we're just gonna go down the rabbit hole today. This is gonna be that kind of day. Looks like black can get two eyes that way though. Yeah. And if we take this away, first of all, it has this problem, right? So we can't quite take that away strongly. We'd have to play this type of move. But then black plays here, we'd have to play here, and black gets two eyes on the inside. So that's pretty cool. Pretty cool move you found. I like it. So white takes that away, but I am worried. Yep. Well, now I'm really worried. I'm very worried for the health of white. Okay, we're giving white one shot to get out. White does not want it. White does not know how to make life. Is that necessary? Is this really needed? I think you just connect. Like, you're worried about this? That's not anything. Maybe you were hallucinating and seeing this move, but then black just plays there. And then, is this a capturing race? So we play there, that's Atari. There. And there's your magic move to win the game. Because black just wins that capturing race by one move. It's so magical. Wow. All right. But in the game, that's not exactly what happened in the game. You played there. And now it's a ko. This shouldn't have been ko, Martin. This was bad. Should have been just dead. I mean, white should have just been dead. But man, this is now just like this epic size ko. Just epic ko. Oh my gosh. It's actually, is it double ko for white? You can connect on that side. It's like, so I think this ko effectively, is it work out to be a one-step ko for black because it's double ko for white, except white can't connect one side? Is that how it works? So white takes that one. You take that one. Or it's not even gonna... You have to... Oh, dear. Why is white responding to this? I think white should just take the ko, right? No, I guess he doesn't, because, yeah, he has to ignore one of white's ko threats. Or black hat would have to ignore one of white's ko threats. Okay. So we're going to turn this entire thing into a life and death problem, but that's just a life. Whoops. No, don't close. There we go. So white just wins? Right? How does black have enough points to win this? Where are the points? Where are the points? Points. And now we take, and then white takes, yep. Effectively, it's a one-step ko. Even though it's a double ko, which is weird. We have to take this threat, have... Oh, no, sorry, it's never a one-step ko, right? Because white would always take the other one. Yeah, so it is just a straight-up double ko. I thought this changed it for some reason, because white could connect over there, but no, white never needs to connect. Yep. Black would take, white would take over here, black would make a ko threat, white, and then white would take back. Yep, you just have infinite ko threats. White is alive in double ko, where it should have just been dead. And, white by 30. Yeah. Not a close game. So, what did we learn? We arrow key through this very quickly. Again, this shape problem should have gone so much better for you. I think you just got to find one more move here. I think this move just works out just fine. Just because you basically have N3 and R2 breaking any sort of capturing sequence on the Q3 stones. So you gotta use your stones, man. Just gotta use them. Oh, that's not the game. This is the game. So basically, over here, black lost everything, and black's playing way behind already. After this, though, again, I don't like the shape for anybody, but especially black, since it was black's area to begin with. I feel like you missed an opportunity... white missed an opportunity to splice through black. This Tanuki is a sort of tone deaf to the weak groups that are on the board. You do get the first move over by those weak groups, but white still unfortunately has a good sequence to fight. White got a little greedy here, so you got a little bit lucky, but then you missed another capturing sequence here. But anyway, white was able to cut through. Yeah, and again, it's reading at this point, right? There's these long sequences that, you know, it's sort of like laid out, and I'm kind of tired, and I'm not reading well either. But this upper right sequence was disaster. Like after you capture the middle, after you somehow fight your way back after having this weak middle group and capture the white after he overextended himself, the game is over. Like, black wins the game. But somehow, it's always somehow, white finds a way. So here, yeah, you can do this. You can even do this reasonably. Like, if you were just really scared. Actually, maybe you can't quite do that. You'd have to. If you just want to give up entirely, you could give up like that, but that would make the game very close. But you shouldn't be this scared of this. You really just shouldn't be scared. You went here. Yeah, if you're just gonna take the corner, this is a better move, right? Because now White's next obvious move is not Sente, right? It's actually a little Sente, surprisingly, because White can still invade here. But you can just block. And it still should be an easy enough game to win for Black. Yeah, and this, why, oh, right, no, don't save as. Are we really scared of this side more? I don't know. Maybe, but this feels bigger, the corner. Like, here White has to play a move like this. But I'm not sure it can actually, oh, this could get out. I see now. Yeah, that's kind of dangerous. That doesn't quite work for Black. Okay, all right, so there is an invasion in here. Oh, maybe Black just responds this way, though. Yeah, that looks good. What's White's next play here? Ko? Maybe Ko? Yeah, reasonable. All right, there's stuff on both sides. There's stuff on both sides. I will give you that. All right, let's look at another game. I'll only pause this for a second while I load it up. Oh, all right. I said I need to load up the other game, but really, what I really needed to do was like freshen up my cup of tea. Because it turns out I'm really tired, and this is a pretty tiring day. And I'm trying to do a game review at night. Well, not at night, in the evening. There's still light outside, technically. So, yeah. After work, let's put it that way. Trying to do a game review after work. You know how that is, right? So, all right, in this game, second game number two, we'll look at. Martin is white. And we have a low Chinese versus Ni Ren Se. And sure, this is all fine. And we have black coming inside. Sure, it'd be a little bit more normal for black to come here. I'm not really going to complain too much about your opponent's moves. Unless they're really bad, then I make fun of them. All right, so we play out this Joseki. This looks very good for white, actually. And then we come in directly. Yeah, I guess I could buy this. It's not going to end terribly well for you. This is Black's plan after all. But there are Joseki to deal with this. Yeah, I was wondering if White should take this G5 point before coming in and just make sure Black's left-hand side is flattened. But this is fine. Yeah, we can play here. In this case, we can still play here. We can still play here. All of these are options. I think you see this one played more when you have something other over here to support it, but it works. Oh yeah, now we're growing the black is growing the bottom very quickly, but we still have a lot of potential in the upper left, so this is still fair. I mean, still fair. And white comes in. At this moment, I would feel really hard pressed not to play this move as white, even though it looks like it gives white another or gives black another strong move to build the bottom. I think getting out of this group is important. Furthermore, it lets you invade here later or here, and it makes sure Black can't do anything too severe against this weakest black group on the board. I guess that's what I should say. because I don't really like the timing of the Tanuki. If you play here, and let's say they play out the sequence, I'm going to presume that you're going to think that black plays a move like here. But I'm not feeling like this is a train wreck. Like, you get to build as well. So I don't know. Just maybe it's more of my style. I would like this group to not get completely sealed in and have some sort of influence somewhere and be able to counterattack the black top right. Okay, so we're going to fight this way. This is fine. In this case, yeah, I mean, it's reasonable. Good. Although I actually don't like that move. I would like that one. This actually does keep significantly more pressure on these two stones. And because you technically already have ownership of the left, maybe not ownership, maybe is the right word, but a stake, a claim to the left, I think you can play high and try to develop it on a large scale. This feels very submissive. Yep, black comes out again. And again, if you had played high, I doubt black would even think about jumping this far. Right, just because you could immediately cut this. I guess in this way you can still immediately cut this, but it's a harder cut for you. Is this good timing? I don't know if this is good timing. It feels like bad timing. I don't know, feels like I just want to make sure black can't ever get settled. And this would help a little bit. Black still has an invasion here, of course, but this stone does help. Keeps things separated. Yeah, and so this is another thing that happened in the last game, Martin, is you like this shape a little bit too much. Like, this is often a shape that you see, like, when white has these stones as well, but it turns out black has these stones. And so black actually still has decent countermeasures to attack this later. Even something as simple as this. And sort of, even the black can split this very, very crude way. Or do this way. You know, just to do these very, very, you know, splitting kind of sequences. Furthermore, black could always just sort of reduce this way as well and build a base for his floating group. Okay, but anyway, black finally responds to your move down here. That's on a large scale. I don't know if it's the best response, but it's certainly a response. It's threatening to capture the whole thing. Wow, all right, so white is just going to stake the whole game on these two stones. So if these two stones live, let's say everything lives on this board right now. Technically, black actually still has kind of a reduction over here. But let's give the benefit of the doubt and say most of these points end up as white. All right, so we're looking at 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24... about 50 points, 55 after Comey or so, for white, compared to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 21 times 2 plus a little few extra for the influence. So black is only in the 40s. So, you know, right now, like, white has maybe a 10-point lead. If these two stones live and don't get punished somewhere else. So if these two stones can live cleanly, white wins this game. Oh my gosh, that's the move black plays? Well, I think white's going to win this game. I just don't even know what the idea here is. I think black is trying to take away this Aji and this Aji with this move while attacking the base of the potential for a base for these white stones. But it does none of those jobs particularly well. Like, in fact, I would say it does none of those jobs well at all. So, yeah. More realistically, I would expect something like black to play here and here. And it still looks like white can try to make a base of some sort, but Black will be very, very annoying about it, and maybe be able to turn this whole center area into a giant black wall. And maybe you can even lean on the top group a little bit and make a wall there and make 20 points in the middle and win the game that way. But this is very submissive. All right, so white just runs out. Yeah, and later on, you still have this K2 attachment too, which is annoying for black. Nope, black's just going to connect. Black just doesn't care. Black is a honey badger. Honey badger don't care. This is... I'm just going to make these points. Unfortunately, unlike the honey badger, black isn't trying to kill anything. This is actually a little bit of a bad exchange. You don't really want to make this exchange just because it gives black really good endgame now to make this group suffer. All right. Oh, man, black didn't even respond locally. Can you play this? Even if you just do this. Does this make everything safe for the rest of the game, and now it's just pure endgame for the rest of the game? That'd be kind of the very, very simple way of doing this. But you play here. Oh, okay, so now we're going to resume the attack on these three stones. It feels like you still need another move here first before you do this. But at least I like your fighting spirit, as opposed to black, who is just like, let me take 8 more points down here. That's a weird move. Again, this is kind of like your house is on fire. Don't go fishing. I can't. That's already a circle. I can't make it a circle again with the circle tool. Do you need to Hane? Hane seems fine. But this is actually a much stronger move against the stick over here. All right. So we're just going to make all these exchanges. This is a little bit of a problem, right? Do we not care about this? That's what black plays. Is this not a real problem? Oh, it's not a real problem if black does that. This is not a real problem. Wow. Oh my god. Why isn't black just like... I don't know. I don't even know what black's trying to do here. What did black accomplish? I thought black was maybe going to try to find a sequence to pull these two stones out or make use of this Atari. All right, but finally, black plays a move that does something. This H10 move potentially puts some pressure back on over here, so we've got some potential. And again, white is trying to keep this group separated. This move is bad, right? Does black need this move right now? Shouldn't black just try to keep the shape bad? Yeah, just because, like, right now, black E11 is actually also Sente. Right? This move is Sente. Because if white, let's say white plays this, black can play this to cut through. So this Atari, I think it wastes a lot of Aji. Alright, and then black comes back and plays this anyway. And Mike just gives up on the three stones. Okay. This is endgame. It's big endgame. It's not the time yet for endgame, right? I think white should play a move like this first. You know, just build this while capturing. Oh, look, it's the exact move black played. Oh, we're going to play all the crude moves as black. That's what black does. Those silly black players. What are we doing? What is going on? I need more tea. This will wake me up / calm me down. So, all right. Black plays there, connecting good. Black plays there. I guess you can play this. You could also just consider doing this. All right, but we played... I like this one better, actually. Even though it leaves this weakness, it doesn't feel like a real weakness to me, right? Because if black does this, we actually just have a liberty capturing type situation. Oh, maybe black actually doesn't. No. Sorry. Black needs black actually can't take that liberty away, right? Oh, no, he can. All right, let me go back. Is this bad? Maybe this is bad. Yeah, it's something. All right, maybe not. Okay, fine. Just play the simple one. That one is complicated. Okay, here. So here, this whole stick is very strong. So we don't actually have to worry about this cut very much. And we just push, and there, and there, and there. I guess this is all mostly forced. Do we have other options? How about there? Black doesn't have time to cut both of these, right? Does this just work? Like, if we cut there, we play here, and then play there. That's like a thing, right? What else can we do? We could cut this way, but that's not really sente. We could actually just connect directly, or probably play that one's better. Okay, so I feel like at some point we actually just have to stop responding directly and just play. Yeah, we could have just played that move directly. We didn't actually need to make this exchange. Yeah, because Black's not going to take time to cut, whereas if you force him to do it now, it doesn't matter. All right, anyway, game on. The game went like this, so we did seal him off. And White's playing there. I have problems with it. This move has obvious defects, right? Like, that you can all see with, like, a 10-foot pole. Right, because there's this, and then there's this. And meanwhile, there's also this cut, too. So, do we have any choices? It looks like Black's going to live now, though, because of all these defects. Looks like we could just give up one stone. And I guess Black still lives in this variation, but we didn't die, so that's always good. But again, I really wanted White just to play here earlier instead of R18, if you guys remember that tragic me screaming into the microphone. Have been very helpful. Wait, what? Oh, Black doesn't do anything with any of these weaknesses and just comes back and plays there. How weird. Why are we doing this now? I guess it's forcing, but it doesn't feel like it's good forcing. Oh, you're trying to make it so Black can't cut both of these in sente or something? Yeah, it seems like a bad exchange, though. Yeah, you ended in gote. Really bad exchange if you're going to save these stones. Yeah, now our center is under duress again. Oh my gosh, what are we doing? So I have questions. Namely, that move. Does that move let Black live? Because it certainly looks like it. That would be sad. Man, all right, Martin, R18 was terrible. Like, you don't need to get yourself into any of this mess. And we're going berserk here. Look at White. So crazy. Oh my gosh. You have a weak group over here. You have a weak group over here. And you're making a third weak group over here. We're trying to lose this game that we were supposed to win. That we had it won. That works. White's fine. Or is he? Can he? Oh, this is interesting. Black descends here. We have this. No, it's not anything. We just play there. Is there any alternative? No. Best shape, it looks like Seki. So what happens if Black actually starts with this one? This is also Seki type shape, huh? Or maybe not even me, that still lives. So after this, yep, there and there. Seems like Black should start from White's more sente side. Because you can do this. Oh, it still lives. Hmm. Interesting. Alright, I'm not reading well. I need to drink more caffeinated tea. Alright, now we get this. That just lives. Or does it? Yeah, it lives. Okay. Hmm. It seems like there should be a killing sequence here. Alright, you guys all have homework. Kill this. That's your homework. We'll go Andrew Jackson style here. Game on. Black cuts... who's cutting who here? Right, these three white stones are looking for help. So black is cutting them off. Great. Alright, so now... they are saved. But black has cut off these four stones to save his group. Black's group... alright, we use one of the weaknesses. Sure. Oh my gosh, it's now Ko. Look at this. This is crazy. All because you played... this all happened because you played R18. I hope you feel good about yourself. Like, none of this would have happened. Like, none of it. Alright, so everyone's just going to be alive. That's way too peaceful. Way too peaceful. Like, black should have died here, and then should have actually been able to punish more. So in the end, it was like a wash, I guess. White lived here, didn't really get punished here. White is almost alive here? Yeah, almost 100% alive, it looks like. So, this game, did it just get boring? It might have just gotten boring. We're gonna try to kill it. Here we go. Does it have eye space? That's already a false eye. We don't actually need to poke there, right? What if we just play here? And there? So... does that kill it? So if we go there and there, we just throw in here. No, it does... oh, maybe? Maybe it still kills it? That would be a false eye. Basically, we'd have to see what kind of forcing moves we have over here. But there is the possibility of it dying, which is more than we had before. But I think after black plays this move right now... I think white should have made all these forcing exchanges first. Oh, now he does it. Okay. Oh, we're still gonna kill it this way. Okay, neat. We just killed white. Black wins. Martin, you died. So, like, the game's over, right? How many moves does this game have left? Or 184? This game has over 100 more moves? How? How is this going to live? Oh, yeah, this is a good move. I think black has to actually respond here. And even then, actually, then this black would be a dragon. It wouldn't be 100% alive. Very interesting. All right. Maybe, does this work for white? No, this doesn't. I'm just hallucinating, right? Like, I'm just crazy. This doesn't work. This is false eyes all over the place. Yeah, good for you. Not a real eye. That doesn't work. Black's alive. That's not eyes. This is not a real Ko. Oh, I see it now. Sorry, I missed that spot. This is how you're going to get alive. Wow. With this Ko. Okay. Oh, wait, this isn't a Ko. Right, yeah, this isn't a Ko. I'm crazy. right? Because all you do is connect there. Oh no, this is, you have to, sorry, the order, it is co. Sorry, all right, I'll show you what I was looking at. Right, white takes this co. I was looking at, playing this one. And then white would finish the co here, but then this just disconnects, right? So that wouldn't be a co. But that doesn't work because white can just play here at any time, threaten to make the second eye. And you have to respond, and now it's co again. Of course. Sorry. Hallucinations. Oh my gosh, we're making the co bigger. I guess that's a local threat, though. Not a good one, but it is a local threat. Oh, that gives black a threat back. I guess this is an even exchange of threats. Oh, no, because white gets another threat, because it can throw in. Yeah, so that's... So we're just going to... Yep, we just exchange all those. And then we threaten this. Cool. Mm-hmm. Yep. Take away the threat by connecting solid. Yep. Threat. Is it a threat? It's a threat to capture these. Which black just gives up. What? Wait, is it not a threat? Why doesn't black take this now? Isn't this what black earned? I don't understand. Black thinks these three are bigger than this? This is way bigger, right? What did you do? Oh, okay, you played that one. Same thing. Actually, yours is better. Yeah, so I mean, black didn't even get really good compensation for this. For, like, having a threat against a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 21, 26, 29 white stone dragon. So what is that? That'd be over 60 points. That'd be like 75-ish points, maybe. Black decided to, or at least negotiated a co where black earns 3 white stones. That's terrible. Yeah, I feel like you just swindled your opponent here a little bit. All right, so now we're doing boring endgame. This looks boring. I am bored. Or we're going to fight this co again. Or a different co, but similar idea. Oh, okay. And that's it. So how do we end up? After all that train wreck, it looks like you have more than enough to win. Maybe you're ahead by a little bit on the board. I didn't really count, though. This is bigger than I thought, actually. In the end, black actually got to capture all. That was supposed to be your territory. You were supposed to kill everything over here. Like, this is all supposed to be white. And black actually made, what is it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Made 22 points there. All right. So maybe it's close on the board. No, actually, it's close, period, right? How many captures? 17, 20? I didn't actually count this. This looks big to my eye, but that was bigger than I thought, too, so maybe my counting's bad. I still think you're up a little bit on the board. Because black only has this, and that, and that's not a lot of points. Yeah. All right, so it came out to be... Yeah, white plus 10. Cool. Actually, you're up by a lot on the board. No Comey, right? Was this No Comey? Yeah, No Comey. Yeah. I still can't believe that black made 20 points there. Over 20 points there. Right? If we just go back. Let's go back like 150 moves. Apparently, we have to go back 200 moves. More than 200 moves. And where's that move where you just played R18? Yeah, if you just play here, I beg the question, what happens to black in this giant area part of the board? Like, what does black have going for him? Like, nothing. Like, this is literally a 100-point territory. As long as you just don't die anywhere else, you're completely 100%, like, winning this game. So, I don't know. Maybe you were thinking, like, you could upset this group. You could invade here and attack it if you had R18, but it's not... even if it worked really cleanly, you'd be working so hard for it. Well, anyway, nice game. But, yeah, we should just take one more clean move to... this move doesn't only just kill these three stones, right? It actually helps build this a little bit. It even helps give a friend to our center weak group. This is what we decided early on, right? When you played these two stones and kind of ignored them, we're going to stake the entire game on making this thing live. And in the end, you didn't even have to make it live. It kind of lived, like, automatically because your opponent decided to save this. And that actually helped. But you almost lost the game. No, wait. Yeah, they didn't almost live because, you know, when black saved this, it looked like you were helping these, but then black was able to cut these off, surround them, force the whole game to a giant co over a 75-point group, which you sort of won by accident, and then somehow black just played a bunch of weak endgame moves and lost the game anyway. That's not quite the right order of sequence, but you get the... I think I'm conveying the spirit in terms of how this game went. But either way, regardless of all that complaining I just did, you play some really strong moves this game. And, you know, your opening was seemed very reasonable, and, you know, it's really hard to say how strong anyone's pure opening is. It seemed good to me. Who knows? We have to start asking AlphaGo these questions. But you played some really strong moves, and, you know, had some good direction. And it felt like you had a strategy, too. Like, that was the other thing that's nice to see in this game, where, like, all right, you have this group here. It's got a lot of space. Black's playing this very, very ambitious move, and you're saying, okay, go kill it. If you can kill it, you win the game. If you don't, you can't. I'd be very scared to Tanuki again. Like, I would probably wouldn't hesitate to add an extra move in this part of the board. But anyway, the other quick shape thing, you like this shape too much. This is useful when you're building something big, and you have potential to build it bigger here. Like, this is proper. This is not that kind of situation, though. This stone here at the 015 point would actually have just been better, just outright better for you if it was anywhere other than there, like in this neighborhood. Like M16, M17, even K17, like anywhere over here, possibly even J17, even though that's a little bit thinner. So yeah, everything in this corner, like this corner, you sucked. I don't know why, you just did. Like, you just played very, like, meh kind of moves. So anyway, that's my conclusion. Martin, thanks for sending these games. You've also been a Patreon supporter, I think, now for over a year, so thank you for that. And I really hope that you know, my videos and lessons have really helped your game. Actually, I know that I have because, again, you sent us that chart, which was super cool. And, you know, I hope you have another great year of Go playing. So thanks again.